tapped over 40 non-government organizations in helping feed families affected by the enhanced community quarantine. With us now for more is Jose Miñana Jr., the Chief Sustainability and Public Affairs Officer of Jollibee Group. Good to have you with us, Pepa. Welcome to the program.
Morning, Kathy. Thank you very much for having me, and morning to all your viewers.
Sure. So tell us, just how important is it to partner with the NGOs? What sort of logistical support did they lend to your efforts?
Well, you know, Kathy, when this thing happened, clearly we, on one side, we're in the food business in Jollibee Foods Corporation, where we have, you know, our food in our warehouse and our commissaries. And on the other side of the spectrum, you have everybody who's being affected here, especially those who are very hungry and those who were dislocated because of the issues coming with the COVID. And so we have to find a way how to bring this, our food, all the way to those who are hungry. And so what we did was to look at two aspects, two groups. One would be the frontliners, our health workers, and our checkpoint personnel manned by the AFP and the PNP. And so we placed 100 million pesos for them, and we placed our stores, over 1,000 stores, to distribute all these products to them. And then the other 120 million pesos would be to communities. And we said, how do we bring this food to the communities as effectively as possible to their doorsteps? And so what we did is we had to partner with several NGOs who could distribute directly to the doorsteps of these families.
And is this initiative going on as we speak? And as there's been a decision to extend the ACQ, will that initiative keep going? You giving food to the most vulnerable and to the frontliners?
Yes, ever since the ECQ was put on March 15 until today, even if the extension is coming over, we are still ongoing, we're still doing that. And this will go on until around May. And we are now preparing for our next phase on how to be able to help all those in need, especially those who are hungry in the communities.
So how much more money are you going to set aside for that? You've already set aside 100 million pesos for the first phase.
Well, actually, Kathy, we've set aside 220 million pesos for both the frontliners and the communities in need. And we're ready to come up with whatever has to be done to help out in terms of our partners and our kababayans.
We're just curious, I'm looking at pictures here, what do you actually serve them? And do they change every day? Is there a certain planned menu?
Well, to those that we have to bring to the communities, what we felt was the most effective way was a frozen marinated chicken that we could bring to them. And this is, as you can see, you know, these are the trucks, and then these are the people who put them together. And what's great about this is we have NGO partners who actually get it from the trucks or reefer vans who go to the communities directly. And it's these frozen packs that we give to them. And then when we have those with those food packs that ready to eat, those that are cooked, are also brought to our frontliners. We know very well that the frontliners don't have enough time to stop. Whether they're in the checkpoint or in the hospitals or the health centers. And so it's very important that we're able to provide them with food that they can eat and, you know, within a few minutes and get back to work right away.
Well, it looks like a logistical challenge that we've found a way to work around with. But what about those who cook the food? How do you keep your employees safe while serving others?
Yes. Well, right now, when this happened, we said that the most important thing that we have to do for our company is to put as number one, our priority would be the health and the safety of our employees and that of our customers over and above everything else. This is really a health issue, so we had to make sure that safety is number one there. And so what we did there, as soon as the ECQ was announced in March 15, we came out with a memo to all employees communicating that we would come out with a 1 billion peso emergency fund, which would fund 1 month salary during that ECQ period of March 15 to April 15, and then the 13th month that will come out in April 30. And then we will also be able to offer continuing salary to our senior citizens and our PWDs during this period, and a special premium for our store employees who continue to work. And definitely, to make them all safe and healthy during this period at the stores and at the commissaries. We have issued masks and thermoscans and vitamins and other equipment that could help them continue to stay safe and serve our customers properly.
So are you going to top up 1 billion pesos now that the ECQ has been extended until May 15th?
We're looking at everything that we can do, Kathy, and make sure that we can help our team members during this difficult time.
All right. Thank you for keeping us up to speed on your initiatives. I much appreciate it. And keep safe, Pepot. Jose Miñana Jr. of Jollibee. I will do. A violinist.